What's up, viewers, subscribers, and agents alike? This your boy, Light Luciferian Prince, coming at y'all live in the morning. I'm mad, people. I'm mad. You know what I'm saying? Because I keep doing these videos, and I can't go to the fucking barbershop, man, because these fucking businesses is bullshit. You know what I'm saying? So until then, I'm going to keep coming at y'all with this funny-ass mustache. Okay? I'm just messing with y'all. I ain't self-conscious at all. No, the reason I'm doing this video today is because someone asked me in a comment section. They asked me about the concept behind why I am Luciferian. Before I proceed, let me say this. I am not a worshiper of anything. I have a conscious contact with my creator. And I also know that in the strict sense of the word, Lucifer means light bearer. So, without further ado, let's get to it. The thing that people don't realize about me is that I have walked off the beaten path of the religious ideology years ago. I've worked for, let's say, the Diocese of North New Jersey for probably over a better part of half of my past life. So for a better part of close to 17 years, I've dealt with, I should say previously, not my previous existence. I'm going to be 32 soon. So in regards to that, that's in my teenage years. I've also walked the path of the ordination process. I have been introduced into the concept of the mysteries in St. John's Cathedral in New York City. And one of the things in the duties that I actually upheld in the position in regards to the established church order was Crucifer. And I didn't even realize what all of this stuff meant. I was like, man, what the fuck is all this shit? And then I started reading and studying into it myself. So my creator allowed me to open my eyes and see beyond the established religious order, because it's all based upon the principles of yesteryear. Yesteryear meaning those people who came before us, meaning those people who are revered and those people who are indeed ourselves. See, when I look at images of so-called Jesus, I realize that, I say, damn, there's some problem with this. I mean, the scriptures reference says that, you know, hair like wool, you know, feet like brass that was burnt in an oven. And then I see this guy, you know what I'm saying? I see this guy. And I'm like, you know, what? So I really start thinking to myself, and I'm saying, you know, this is not right. You know, this is not right. This can't be right. You know? And then I didn't even realize that, hell, I'm sitting here revering a concept from my lineal descendancy, which is basically Kemetic wisdom. So I realized that the papacy and the Roman Catholic Church and the Anglican churches, which I actually have been actually a part of, that was yesteryear, have taken this and adopted it to themselves, and they've made it so confusing and so spiritually bounding unto people to make them reliant on them for wealth and resources and usage of them. So I fucking say, God damn, this is crazy as hell. You know what I'm saying? And my creator pulled me out of that. It pulled me out of that. You know, I no longer associate with the Jesuit-ran organization of the Anglican Church. And in any instance, I don't even step foot in those places. I have nothing to do with those places. And to be honest with you, I can't fucking stand it. It's a bunch of sweaty people who smell like yesterday, who got a bunch of problems, that come there and they cook bad mac and cheese. That's what church is. I I can't do it. So, in my personal life, I've adopted this concept to bear light on subjects, and I realized that the grand orchestrage, which is Nimrod, who indeed himself was a Negro, is actually what Christianity is based on. And I said, whoa, I said, wait a minute. See, if you look online, you Google research worship of the Black Madonna, you'll see popes bowing down to an image that looks like myself. It's dark. So I started looking into myself and I said, well, wait a minute. So if these people say the devil is supposed to be this and the devil is supposed to be bad and all this, what are these people, what are they calling the devil? And I realized that the Anglo-Saxon ideology, Zernebogus, was the image that they were worshiping and they were revering because they feared it. So I said, damn, now I see why white people fear people like myself. And yes, I have horns. That's the first time I showed you, but it goes a part of my ideology collectively, and I believe it, and I know for a fact that, damn, the mystery behind religion is the simple fact of the reliance on the spiritual system of the Cosmic priesthood that transmigrated into Greece. And I said, damn, now I'm on to something. So now I realize why. Today, there are so many Anglo-Saxon preachers who always leech and, you know, file and rank so many poor urban communities. Bam. You know, so I really started seeing all of this stuff for myself, and I started bearing light on all these subjects. The reason why I adopted this way of life is because everything that I deal with does not have to do with anything religious. It has to do with socioeconomic, political, and cultural involvement and development of people who want to be aware. Luciferianism, to me, is nothing to do with worship. You have to realize when you use that word, you have to realize that there's other words that also go along with the concept that you're on a vessel. So, worship, relationship, scholarship, it all has to do with you being on a vessel. It's called planet Earth. You have to realize that the usage of these words also go along with the concept of the maritime ideology behind how law works and how you're even viewed. A vessel. You're moving on the universal sea. So I said, damn, all this stuff is very, it's very important, because from the time of our infancy, we've been told that this is a water planet. So, okay, we believed it, but we didn't even know what the concept really was. And you are on the mundane egg on the universal sea. So what you're basically doing is you're traveling through time, because the way you began was in water, and you were born in water, whether you believe it or not. However you got here, trust me, you came through some sort of fluid. So your in your microcosmic beginning began on a macrocosmic scale. So I said, well, damn, well, religion, they really don't teach me any of this stuff. And guess what? My creator showed me this, you know. And as I said before, the concept is to bear light. It's to bear light. It's to be a light bearer. It's to bear light on the truth from the root of the word lux. Luxifer, Lucifer means light bearer. And that's what I was born to be. A person who has the awareness, the conscientiousness of knowing the truth and fulfilling what the purpose of the truth is. That's why I chose my path. So, with that being said, this is the reason why I expound upon so many subjects on my channel, because it's important for people to know the truth. I sincerely believe that. But if people want to stay, you know, totally oblivious to whatever is going on in life, that's fucking perfect. And I'm not trying to convert anybody or make any, I don't have any of that stuff going. I'm not a cult. I don't have any of that. And no, you can't equate me with those Anglo-Saxon Luciferians who mix Satanism with wisdom, and they're confused. Okay, and I have nothing to do with those people at all, in no form or fashion. I don't practice any sort of customs, traditions. I don't do any of that shit. I just live life in the conscientiousness of being aware of what my creator has endowed me with so I can go back home. That's all. You know? See, people have been so formulated with religion, and they've been so conditioned, so to speak, that their minds can't come out of the concept, because the word religare means to bind. So Kelter Mensa, who's always inside the comment section saying shit, why don't you start your own channel? And don't worry about the linguistics of mine, because I'm kicking ballistics on mine. So do something with yourself, you Call of Duty dick jacking motherfucker. But again, it's light bearer. It's to bear light on the truth. The truth is, and things are evident as they are, and what will be, shall be. Stay tuned. And agents, fuck you. Peace. Lay y'all.